Hi, in this tutorial I want to show you how to use Yearbook Creator, which is an InDesign add-on that we've developed that really speeds up the process of making a yearbook that has loads of pictures of kids and staff with their captions of the names underneath each photo. Each class, each grade is divided separately, is displayed separately on a new spread. And all of these things can take a long time to do by hand. With Yearbook Creator, it's really quite easy. Let me show you how it works. I'm starting here with a one-page spread in InDesign, and it just has a text frame open on it. We'll select the text frame and run from the Scripts panel, Yearbook Creator. The first thing we're asked to do is to browse to the data file. Now, when a photographer takes pictures of all kids in a school, usually there's a data file which is standardized. It's called datafile.txt, and if we have a quick look inside, you can see that it's divided. It's basically a CSV comma separated file. There's a column for the grade here, and then there's the image name and the last name, first name. The image name is the path to the image. So all of this information is stuff which the Yearbook Creator is going to be reading and using to create the yearbook. So we'll just select that file and open it, click OK, and tell the Yearbook Creator where it is, click OK again, and it reads the file. And in this left panel, let's have a look what we've got. In this left panel, it lists all the grades that appear in the data file, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. And we can decide if we want to include all grades or not. So I can uncheck everything at this stage. And let's say I'm just going to make a high school yearbook. So it's just going to be grades 10, 11, 12, and faculty and staff. So just those 4 years are going to appear in this yearbook. So I check those. And let's say that I want faculty and staff to be first in the book. So I can change the order like this. And that's done. Now, in the row and columns option, we set the number of rows. The actual size of the text frame, the size, the width of the display is decided by this text frame that we've chosen before we ran the script, and we can divide it into as many rows and columns as we want. So it says here that we're going to divide it. We've chosen to divide it into 4 rows, 9 columns. Perhaps that's a bit much. Let's make it 6 columns. Then in points, you can choose units here, the points, inches, centimeters. In points, you can specify the gap between the rows and the columns. Next, layout options. Each picture is going to have an object style attached to it, an object style in InDesign. And here we specify which style we want for the photo and which style we want for the caption. So if you want to add a border to a picture, also if you want to use frame fitting options in the object style, you can do that here. Caption outdent lets the caption, the name of the kid, actually stretch out to the right and the left of the photo underneath it, so that if it's a long name, it will still have room, and the height of the caption again in points. And that's it. Click OK, and the script runs, and it starts reading the text file, finding the photos, adding the captions, laying out the grades. Each grade starts on a new spread, which is something you can't do with data merge. And the way the pictures are laid out is as inline objects in a text frame. So that's done. And it shows an error log. It opens up an error log in case there are any missing photos that are mentioned, referenced in the data file, but couldn't actually be found in any of the folders. It will tell you, but luckily there aren't any in this case. So this is a result of running the script, and what we've got here is the page with the staff, and then when a new grade begins, it begins on a new spread, and then the next grade, we did 9, 10, 11, and 12, and that's it. You've got the pictures of all the people, you've got the captions underneath. And let me show you what's actually done, because it's very interesting how it works and how flexible it is once it's been laid out initially. So the first thing you see is that all of these images are actually inline frames. I can select them, and that gives a lot of flexibility. For instance, let's say that I want on the first page of each grade to have room to write a title. I can simply reduce the size of the text frame like this, and perhaps bottom align the frame so that all the pictures at the bottom here. Snap that, and now I've got room here to write a title. Call it staff. Just make that bigger to fit. So there you go, you've got your heading. And all of the pictures have reflowed here so that nothing's been lost. And again, if I don't like the arrangement here on the bottom line, because this is actually inline frames, I can use the regular text line option, so I can have the bottom line centered just by clicking on that. That's very useful. It's a very flexible way of working. Another thing I can easily do is I can simply cut out a person if they're in the wrong place, cut, and I can paste them, let's say here, and everything reflows to fill the gap. Now, this again is actually not part of the add-on anymore. Yearbook Creator has done its work, but the way it works is it sets it up in a very flexible way. Then let's move on to the first class, and again, you can have a different design here. You can just select the, you need to select between photos to select the text frame. I can make this a bit narrower if I want to have a title, perhaps, which is longer, narrow, call it grade one. I'll just type grade one and fit that. I'm using a different script here to fit it to the frame. So this is grade one, and all of the photos have readjusted as needed. Now, grade 2, it's not grade 2 actually, we said 9, 10, and 11, so this is 9, this is 10. Again, starts a new page, so you can just feature one item on this page if you want, that's one option. Make it bigger, or one or two photos, excuse me, let's just drag this, and make it bigger, so you can feature a photo on this page if you like, or two photos, or instead you can delete the actual page. And have the next grade start on a right-hand page. That's also fine. And again, if you need to delete or copy or insert more photos, a late kid has come to class and you want to add him to the yearbook, you missed the thing, he's not in the regular file, very easy to add. You can just make a gap here, you delete this and cut it. You can repaste it elsewhere. You can, let's say, add a new kid here, paste, and pasting a few times. So it's a very flexible script, and makes the hard part of creating yearbooks very easy. If you need customization of this script, it's something that we can do, because many yearbooks are going to be slightly different. Maybe the date, your data file is organized in a slightly different way, even though this is a standardized data file. But otherwise, the script is available, and you should contact idextras.com to find out more about it. That's admin@id-extras.com. I'll be very happy to give a live demonstration and discuss your exact yearbook needs. But this script has been tried and tested and is being used in production. And I've heard from happy users that it's really saving them huge amounts of time and work to lay out yearbooks. So thanks for watching, and do be in touch. Bye.